Waging War on Corruption. Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. Big Brother. Mainstream media. Government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
Now, coming up in about 20 minutes, we'll go right back to your calls, Rich and Wildman and others that are patiently holding. Talking about this Ebola outbreak in Africa now coming to the U.S. and the president won't to try to stop flights into the country, even though that was the default with the CDC previously. Governor Jindal has called for that. We are joined by Representative Walter B. Jones from North Carolina. And, of course, he's one of the few Ron Paul types we've still got in Congress and is leading the charge up there on so many issues that are near and dear to the Constitution and Bill of Rights. But he has introduced legislation this year that's now gotten a lot of attention. And we've had a lot of different military people on and whistleblowers who have seen the 28 pages of the 9/11 report showing clearly the Saudis were involved and our government knew and basically had a stand down. He's been working to get that released, and he joins us to talk about that and other issues. So, Congressman Jones, thanks for coming on.
Alex, delighted to do it, and I want to thank you. This is an important issue because for our country, if the American people don't know the truth about 9/11, there is no hope for our nation, in my opinion. So I'm delighted to be on your show.
Well, thank you, sir. You know, it's perfect timing to have you on. It's coming out that our own government with NATO has been arming ISIS. They've been that our so-called Gulf State partners have been arming them. This is just a replay of what we've seen before.
Alex, there's no question about it. That's why I have, it's a totally different issue, but very quickly, I have joined some of my colleagues asking John Boehner to bring us back. Let's have a debate on this Syrian situation, and I'm very disappointed that Speaker Boehner will not do that, and he keeps saying, well, if the president asks us to bring you back, we will. And I've said to Mr. Boehner in letter form, Mr. Boehner, you have the authority as leader of the House to bring us back at any time to let the House debate and discuss.
Well, let's talk about that a little bit more before we go to break and come back with the 9/11 Commission redacted 28 pages.
Okay.
We've seen the British military come out and say that the British government should stop arming the radicals. We've seen our own military, as you know, on the Hill in closed hearings saying the same thing. I'm proud that our military has been against this from the beginning, but our political leaders on both sides of the aisle have been for it.
Well, Alex, it's very disappointing. We did have a debate on the floor of the House about arming or training the Syrian rebels, and sadly it passed. And I spoke out in opposition to it with the 2 minutes I had on the floor, and other members in both parties spoke out against it. And I do not understand why the president continues to bypass Congress. He bombed Libya, which was unnecessary. And he continues to want to bomb in Syria. I think it raises legal questions, but that's another issue. I'm not an attorney, as you know. But to me, Congress is not following the Constitution, and therefore I'm very disappointed in the leadership that would not allow us to have a debate. And I actually wrote a letter to Mr. Boehner last week asking that when we come back for what's called the lame duck session, we can at least have a 2 or 3 day debate on this Syrian situation because, in my opinion, the policy is a failed policy to begin with.
Jones.house.gov, and when we come back, we're going to get into declassify the national campaign to reveal the 28 censored pages of the 9/11 Commission. But didn't you also introduce legislation that if Obama continues to launch wars without congressional approval, that impeachment would get triggered, sir?
Well, I'm sad to tell you, I did introduce it, but I can't even get a hearing on the House side, and we're controlled by Republicans, and they won't even give me a hearing on that issue.
Incredible. Well, doing the right thing is what counts. And just like Ron Paul would introduce stuff and no one would co-sponsor it, down the road he got a lot of co-sponsors. And I know you are getting a lot of support for your declassification movement of the 28 pages. We'll talk about that with Congressman Walter Jones, a true hero of telling the truth and liberty, the Republican from North Carolina. We'll be right back. It's jones.house.gov. Stay with us. He's in.
When you're out on the road, the last place you want to be is on the road. But if the unfortunate happens, you'll be glad you were wearing diamond gussets.
There's a place down in Tennessee where they make blue diamond gusset jeans. They sew pride in every stitch. Guarantee you love the way they fit. They put a diamond gusset in the crotch where you need it most. Blue diamond gussets got it, others don't.
We turn jeans inside out. Diamond gusset jeans, made in the USA with unparalleled quality. Our Defender motorcycle jeans combine gusset comfort with Kevlar protection, so you can ride all day with confidence. Order yours at gusset.com. Diamond gusset jeans got it, others don't.
General, what do you think about the FBI saying that there was a terror alert on Monday about a potential Fort Hood situation?
The police are shoving people, shoving Alex, shoving the crowd.
Here we go, folks, I'm being assaulted.
Whether it's the radio show, the news websites, documentary films, or the nightly news, InfoWars is the tip of the spear.
Is this another false flag stage attack to take our civil liberties and promote homeland security while sticking the hands down on the pants on the streets?
It's up to us to set brush fires in the minds of men and women everywhere. And that's what PrisonPlanet.tv is designed to do.
You watch the Assad regime is going to be blamed or accused of using chemical weapons against the so-called rebels.
What we see now is a war against reality. It's a war against the truth.
It's more vital than ever that supporters of freedom become members of PrisonPlanet.tv and share their membership with up to 11 friends and family. Visit InfoWarsNews.com today. Become a member, share your membership, and help take the InfoWar to the next level. Alex Jones here to tell you about how you can help spread liberty worldwide while also enjoying what I have found to be the best tasting 100% organic coffee on the planet. For more than a decade, my favorite coffee has come from the high mountains of southern Mexico, where the Chiapas farmers grow their unique shade-grown Arabica beans. We have now managed to secure these sought-after beans in a highly customized blend. Discover and try a bag of the Patriot Blend 100% organic coffee at InfoWarsLife.com. This coffee gives you a long, smooth pick-me-up for hours without the headaches and heartburn that so many other coffees give me personally. Hands down, this is my favorite coffee. And it's taken us years to secure connections directly to the Chiapas Mexican farmers. Drop by the site today, order a bag or two, and I don't think you're going to be disappointed. Available in original or with our immune support infusion blend, you will be supporting a free press, all the while enjoying a truly great-tasting cup of my favorite coffee. Available at InfoWarsLife.com.
He's the T-Rex of political talk. Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network.
Obama has promised to bankrupt coal in this country that supplies, well, did supply about 60% of our power, now about 40. Energy prices have almost doubled in the last 6 years, electricity. Well, the Democrat Senate candidate, Allison Grimes, a Grimes staff caught on hidden camera. She's lying about support for coal industry. U.S. Senate candidate Allison Lundgren Grimes is lying about her support for the state's coal industry, according to Kentucky Democrats, including members of her campaign team, who were caught on a hidden camera video saying, yeah, we go out, we shoot guns in public, we say we're conservative, but once we get in, we're going to bankrupt coal. Well, Obama famously said that as well. So that's what they're doing. I don't own one stock in coal. I own zero coal. But I'm against shutting it down because it's clean. It powers our country. I don't want to get off down a rabbit trail with Congressman Walter B. Jones of North Carolina, who's introduced legislation to impeach Obama if he continues to launch wars without congressional approval. He's introduced legislation that's getting a lot of co-sponsors as well to release the 28 pages of the 9/11 Commission report, jones.house.gov. But let me just ask you briefly what you think about coal being shut down in this country, throw a wild card at you, a curveball, and separately about the Ebola flights being allowed to come in out of West Africa. What's your take on both those issues, sir?
Well, I think any opportunity to use any type of energy to help the American people, as long as it's clean and safe, and that's been proven about the coal industry. They've made gigantic gains in trying to make sure that their product is clean, and I think they've done a great job. I think it should be a way that we can have that option. And as far as Ebola, I have already written to the White House, joined many of my colleagues to say, stop letting these people come into this country.
So you're on record with colleagues writing a letter to the president saying, stop the flights.
Absolutely.
And there's almost no media coverage of this. And the head of the CDC is out saying, quote, it will make Ebola spread if we don't let them come in. I mean, that is the most asinine thing I've ever heard.
I would agree with you, and Alex, that is why many of my colleagues from North Carolina and other states are asking the administration to use the authority they have to protect the American people from any type of disease that's got the potential to be an epidemic. And I can't explain.
You've been around a while, and does it seem like we're living in the twilight zone? I've never seen government act this way, this reckless on so many fronts. Our southern border's wide open while they're saying ISIS terror attacks are imminent. It's just bizarre.
Well, you know, I've made the statement many times that I believe that we are at a crossroads in this country, and if we don't make the right decisions, in the next presidential election, there will be no hope for America. And I'm a big Rand Paul supporter, by the way.
Well, God bless you, my friend. I tell you, it's just so frightening when you have children or grandchildren.
It really is.
To just
Alex, really, another subject very quickly. The debt of this nation. In the year 2000, our debt in America was $5.6 trillion. Today, it is over $17.7 trillion. How much longer economically can a country continue to borrow money from foreign governments to pay its bills before it collapses? I don't know. Then you got Ebola, and then you got all these other issues. I mean, we could do another show if you want to on the 28 pages, because I will tell you the truth. That in itself, the 28 pages, the American people, the families of 9/11 have a right to see what's in there. And I can honestly tell you, when you've got the former two chairmen, Senator Bob Graham, retired now, lives in Florida, from Florida, and Richard Shelby, still in the United States Senate, and their inquiry commission said that, yes, it should be declassified. Then you've got Hamilton and Kane, recently as 3 weeks ago, former members of the House, and then the former governor of New Jersey, Kane, saying it should be declassified, and there's no reason the American people should not see the truth. It was George Bush that classified this information. Mr. Obama owes nothing to George Bush, but he does owe to the families of 9/11 the right to see the 28 pages, and certainly the American people. And Mr. Obama has told the families twice that he would allow them to see the 28 pages, and Steve Lynch, a Democrat, and myself have written to President Obama in April of this year reminding him that he made this promise, and he needs to keep his word to the 9/11 families. We stand on top of that. We call the White House every now and then. We have been told as recently as 2 weeks ago that in the next 4 or 5 weeks they would give us an answer to our letter.
Extremely powerful, and that's the main reason Congressman Walter B. Jones has joined us today, is to talk about what he can say is in those pages. I've talked to military sources, other congressional sources. You were on at the first of the year when you first introduced the legislation. What can you tell us, without violating supposed national security laws that they use to hide all these crimes, what can you tell us is in the 28 pages?
Well, what I can tell you in the 28 pages is nothing about national security. It is about relationships, and it could be somewhat embarrassing to the Bush administration. But I'm telling you that the American people need to know those people in Saudi Arabia who were not our friends at that time. And I'm not going to the very top of the Saudi leadership, but I'm just saying that the Saudis need to let the American people know who within their country, who was involved in financing this 9/11 attack. And that's been in the press. I'm not telling people anything that I read, because that's been in the press. That's speculation.
That's right.
We've done two press conferences with family members who lost loved ones. One in March, Thomas Massey.